Hi, in this video we are going to have a look at the game Two Dots. The goal of the game is to connect dots, and by connecting them you can remove them, connecting dots of the same color, that is. This can be done vertically or horizontally, but not diagonally. So for example, I can connect these five blue dots. They will be removed and they will work towards the target that you see at the top of the screen. You have to remove 15 of each color dots, and we have 30 moves. You see that at the left top, 30 moves to do so. Well, let's do the green one first. You cannot go back and double, then you just remove your connection again. So you cannot remove all the yellow ones at the same time, even though they are connected. You have to be able to make some path through there. So let's just play it a bit. Now, this is kind of a special move. If you are able to make a square or any rectangle, connect connect them, then you have to reconnect from the to the start again. Then you remove all the blocks of that, all the dots of that color. So that is a very nice move. And if you start playing this, you will see that a lot of times that move is involved in clearing a field, and that can really help you a lot. Blue ones. Need to have a bit more green. Even though we already have enough yellows, it can still help to remove all the yellows like this and all the reds like this, so that we get more of the green and blue that we actually need. Now you can remove all the green. And then, just to show, it can also be a rectangle like that, 2x6. So making these shapes, and sometimes you can also say, okay, I'm going to remove something to being allowed in the next, being able in the next turn to get this rectangle. So that really helps with completing levels. And that's actually the secret trick they're going to teach us now when you go through the tutorial. When in doubt, just make squares. And then clearing a level goes very fast. And that is, I find this move almost too strong, too good. And that is, in my opinion, a bit of a drawback of the game. It does feel the game needs something like this. If you add from a lot of point of view, it has some similarities with Candy Crush-like games or any Match 3 games, where you have different colors and you have to reach certain targets, have certain moves, and instead of swiping, it's connecting. What it really misses here is, you have to make the connection yourself, so you can never have this kind of thing that you remove some and then a lot falls away. And this square is making that kind of happen a bit. But I don't think it's that great, because it's really too good a move. If you keep doing that, then you will, maybe a lot of levels will be quite easily completed. especially since if you start and you have this kind of open field later, you will also have fields. I guess they do that because of that, that the, there are some empty spaces in between, so it becomes more difficult to make squares. But if you have a field like this, yeah, once you start making squares, it can, yeah, can it becomes a bit more likely that you can quite easily make a next square and a next square, and that really can help you complete levels quite fast. So now, yeah, they also really teach us to play for these squares. Okay, remove something so that you can make a square the next time. Already see yellow square here, blue square here, and here. Now I don't right away see a new, oh yeah, here is a green square. Well, it just keeps going and we are already done. So in a very limited amount of moves, you can clear a field. This gives me the feeling that early on the game is quite quite easy, but maybe more challenging levels. We will see more challenging levels later on. So we can again remove those so that we can make a yellow square. And when you make these kind of things, you also will see, you probably already have noticed that, yeah, when you remove yellow, not only all yellows will be removed, also no new yellows will appear. So that makes it, yeah, relatively easier to get a next, more, or not easier, more likely that you have a next square as well. No squares here. Not a lot of yellow. Let's not do that one. Let's see. Oh, almost missed that possibility to make another square. But yeah, this is maybe one way of making it difficult, although we still have a lot of moves that they just don't provide a lot of the color that we need. If it's going to be like this, then maybe we are not going to make this level, but that is, yeah, I find just, this is just a bit frustrating in the sense that they are just not providing any, or no, it's not like not any, but not a lot of yellows for us. And it can still take quite a lot of moves. Let's see, do we see anything nice in the next level? Or are we going to... so one nice thing is that we can also make a square like that. Remove everything. And that is already it. Keep making squares. Where can we make a next square? I don't see it right away. yellow square. After that we can do a purple one and then a green one. Red and yellow and done. Okay, well that's it. I do like this game. I find the stuff sometimes there is some nice storyline or some nice features around the game. I don't really like it here. At times it's a bit confusing. I tend not to look into it too much and just play the main game and not be bothered with the rest. I do give this game 8 out of 10 stars. As I said, I do quite like it. It's not perfect, but definitely very good entertainment. Could have been a bit more challenging, I guess, but maybe I will run into that when I get to later levels. Thanks for watching this video, and if you do have any comments or any questions, that's always much appreciated. Bye.